بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له العزيز العظيم، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الناصح الكريم. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تمسك بسنته إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام والسنة. All praise and thanks belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guiding us to Islam and for guiding us to the Sunnah. Alhamdulillah, and continuing looking at those things that are vital and needed and necessary in order for one to purify their soul, then undoubtedly it will be the lowering of the gaze. Qala Fadilatu Shaykh Abdul Razzaq bin Shaykh Abdul Muhsin Al-Abbad Al-Badr Hifdhahumullah Ta'ala. فيحتاج العبد الحاجة ماسة. He said that the abd, he is in tremendous need, vital need. إلى إغلاق المنافذ التي تدنس نفسه. He said that the slave is in vital need of closing the windows of those things that will corrupt their soul. Closing the windows, closing the passageways, closing the turuq, the ways by way in which the soul will become corrupted, the soul will become polluted. It is incumbent that we pay very close attention to the likes of this, because there is nothing like safety. There is nothing like being safe. And undoubtedly, it is not a test of a person's iman or to show the strength of an individual's iman that they subject themselves to trials and tribulations to see how they stand, to see how they will stand up in the face of this trial, in the face of this tribulation, as a test of their commitment, as a test of their religiousness, as a test of the strength of their iman. No, but rather the soul that is wise, the individual that is smart, is an individual that avoids the fitna. Is an individual that avoids the fitna. So from the greatest means of escape from the fitna, then it is to avoid it to begin with, not to subject oneself to it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inside of his noble book, he says, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Allah ta'ala, he says what means, and say to the believers, say to the believing men, to lower their gaze. And say to the believers to lower their gaze. وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. And to safeguard their private parts. ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ. Because this is purer for them. This is purer. This is better for them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. And Allah is well aware. Allah is well informed of what you do. Allah is well aware. Allah is well informed of what they do. When one contemplates on this ayah, and in particular they contemplate on the order in which things were mentioned, they will see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ, that they are to lower their gaze before he mentioned, وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ, and guard their private parts, guard their modesty. Lowering the gaze was mentioned first, and there is a great wisdom in this. And when we reflect upon this, perhaps we will understand the importance of lowering the gaze as relates to the purification of the soul. Because after that, after mentioning both of those things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ. This is more pure for them. This is purer for them. This is better for them. نعم. قال أبو حيان الأندلوسي. أبو حيان الأندلوسي, he mentioned, قُدِّمَ غَضُّ الْبَصَرُ عَلَى حِفْظُ الْفَرْجِ لِأَنَّ النَّظَرْ بَرِيدُ الزِّنَى. He said that the lowering of the gaze was mentioned before the guarding of the private parts because the look is the postcard of fornication. The look is the postcard of zina. An individual will not fall into zina except that there comes before it muqaddimat. There comes before it certain things that will lead to it. Certain things that are the leadway to it and the doors to it. A person just doesn't jump into it, but rather you will find that there are things that will precede it, from the look, from the talk, so on and so forth. All of these things precede it, precede the evil end of fornication, precede the evil end of adultery and the like. Where does it start? It starts with the gaze. It starts with the look. And this is what is meant by another baridu zina, that the look is the postcard for zina. The look, the Shaykh goes on to mention, ra'id al-fujur. The look, then this is the scout. This is the scout for evil. This is the scout for lewd sexual acts. This is the reconnaissance, you see. This is the reconnaissance for that evil, lewd sexual act is what? Is the look. So therefore, if an individual wants to conquer their soul as relates to this affair, then they have to conquer the look. They have to restrain the look. They have to lower their gaze. The fight begins in where? In the look, in the lowering of the gaze. If a person is able to lower their gaze and they are successful at this level, then they will be even more so safe as relates to their private parts. Then they will be safe, bi'nillahi ta'ala, as relates to their private parts. Whereas, when the person is afflicted by the look, then this will eventually lead, if unchecked, to falling into fornication. Why? Because the individual will look until the look is no longer enough. Then they will have to touch. Then they will have to experience. And once they reach this level, then they will fall into that which Allah Ta'ala has made haram. So, Abu Hayyan, he goes on to mention, he says, وَالْبَلْوَى and the calamity fihi, the calamity in the look, أَشَدُّ وَأَكْثَرُ, that the calamity that is inside of the look, then this is greater, this is more dangerous, and this is more prolific. This is more, this is in more of abundance. And when one reflects upon this, and they reflect upon the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he mentions that the eye has, yani commits its zina, and that is by the look. When one reflects upon this, one will realize that yes, it is more greater as due to or as relates to what was aforementioned. And it is more of abundance, it is more prolific. Why? Because the zina that is committed by the eye is way more than the zina that is committed by the private parts. Way more. An individual by way of his eye, just in walking in the marketplace, could commit zina with the eye so many times in the marketplace without the private parts acknowledging and asserting to the truthfulness of that. Without the private parts affirming that. Meaning, they could look and look and look and look at all of these things that are haram without actually falling into the zina. So it is more prolific, the harms that come from the look, than it is that which will transpire to the private parts. And all of this has to be avoided, because the one will lead to the other. The one, it will lead to the other. And the shaitan, he understands how to trick the children of Adam. The shaitan, he doesn't come to you and say from the beginning, go fornicate with her. But rather the shaitan, he'll come to you and say, look at her. Look at her again. Look at her again. Look at this, look at that. Look out for this, search for that. So on and so forth. But then that would eventually lead to what? It will lead to the person talking to her. It will lead to the person introducing himself to her. It will lead to the person having inappropriate interactions with her verbally, or be that by text, or be that online, and so on and so forth, which will eventually lead to a meeting. That will eventually lead to, wa'iyadu billah, the fornication or the adultery. But where did it start? It started from the look. It started from the gaze. So this is more greater. This is a shed. Why? Because it leads to that which is tremendously dangerous. It is more prolific. Why? Because you will find people, their eyes are unchecked. Their eyes are unchecked. They don't check their eyes to the same extent that they check their private parts. Now, if we want to purify our soul, then we cannot allow these windows in our head to bring into it corruption, to bring into our heart corruption. We can't allow these doors, these windows inside of our head to bring corruption to our heart, to bring filthiness to our soul, to bring pollutants to our soul, because we're trying to purify the soul. So beware of those things that will contaminate it. And from the greatest of those things that are a contaminating factor to the soul, then undoubtedly it is these eyes. هذا أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين فاستغفروا فإنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد يا عباد الله قال إمام السعدي إمام السعدي he mentions فإن من حفظ فرجه وبصره طهر من خبث الذي يتدنس به أهل أهل الفواحش. He says that the person who safeguards his private parts and they safeguard their sight, they safeguard their gaze, then they will have been cleansed, they will have been cleaned from the filth that the people of lewd sexual acts are filthy by, that they are dirty with. Those things that have polluted them and rendered them disgusting, they will be safe from this if they do what? If they safeguard their eyes and they safeguard their private parts. Naam. وَزَكَّتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. And their actions will be purified. بسبب ترك المحرم. Why? Due to the reason of them leaving off the haram. Leaving off the haram. الذي تطمع إليه النفس وتدعو إليه. That haram that the soul craves for it. It desires it and it calls to it. The soul it craves for it. It desires it and it calls to it. نعم, to look at the haram, to gaze upon the haram, stare at the haram, and so on and so forth. Leave these things off for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Leave these things off and look for the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because as Imam Sa'di he mentions, فَمَنْ تَرَكَ شَيْئًا لِلَّهِ عَوَّدَهُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا مِنْهُ. Whoever leaves off something for Allah, Allah will replace it with that which is better. Allah will give you better. So if we make it our intention to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to leave off the haram for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal will reward us by replacing what we have left off for his sake with something that is better, something that is great, something that is tremendous. And only Allah ta'ala knows to the extent that those good effects will lie. For example, an individual who is in need of being married, is in need of being married. So you find they're having problems lowering their gaze. If they leave off looking at the haram, if they leave off gazing at the haram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them with a righteous spouse who is pleasing to the eye, so on and so forth. Wallahu a'lam wa a'lam. These are just an example. This is an example of the good that can come from that. And only Allah ta'ala knows to the extent that he will bless a slave, to the extent that he will give in place of that haram that was left, that beautiful and that outstanding and wholesome thing of which we probably can't even imagine. Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions that أكثر معاصي, most of the sin, إنما تولدها من فضول الكلام والنظر. He says that most of the sin, contemplate on this, most of the sin, that it will result in overindulging in speech and overindulging in looking. Overindulgement in speech and overindulgement in looking. Contemplate, contemplate, as Sheikh Abdul Razak he mentions, When we look at it from the standpoint, leaving off looking at things that are haram, leaving off speaking in manners that are haram and so on and so forth. He mentions, من حسن إسلام المر تركه ما لا يعني. That from a person's good Islam is that he leaves off that which does not concern him. لا يعنيه أي لا ينفعه. That which does not concern him, meaning that which does not benefit him. From what? That this is in general. So if he were to leave off indulging in speech that's not necessary, if he leaves off looking at things that are haram, so on and so forth, and other than that, from that which enters into this, then this undoubtedly will enter into a person's good Islam, or how a person could achieve having good Islam, leaving off that which does not concern him. A person looking at the opposite sex in the street, it does not concern him. They're looking at things that at the end of the look, you can't have it anyway. So what benefit is it for you to look at it? No benefit. Likewise for the sisters, looking at the men in the street, looking at the men online or in the magazine and so on and so forth, and at the end of the affair, you can't have him anyway. So what's the point? What's the point? It's all bad. There's no upside. You gain haram, 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 and that's it. You don't get the object that you're staring at. You just get a bunch of sin. So what's the point? What's the point, right? It is a must that we fight against our souls. Because as they say, easier said than done. Na'am. No one is coming here saying, oh, this is easy, it's black and white, do it like that. No, we're saying that it's hard. This is why it's highlighted. Because it requires jihad. Na'am. It requires jihad. We have to make jihad against ourselves. We have to make jihad against the evil inclinations of our souls. We have to make jihad against the evil desires that we may have. We have to struggle. We have to fight. We have to struggle and fight and struggle and fight and keep struggling, keep fighting. This is the way. This is the way. Understand, Imam al-Qayyim, he mentions that these two affairs of talking too much and looking too much, huma awsa', istami'u, awsa' madakhil ash-shaytan. These are the biggest gates. These are the biggest doors that shaytan could come at you with. You understand? The Salaf used to say, it is incumbent that you pay attention to the door that shaytan comes to you and you guard it. You have to guard the door that shaytan comes to you. Because what? He don't come to everyone the same way. Maybe this person has a fitna with money. So shaytan will come to him from the door of money, from the standpoint of money. So he has to be on his guard as relates to money. So he doesn't cheat people. He doesn't rob from people. He doesn't swindle people, so on and so forth, because he know money, that's his problem. Na'am. So he has to be on guard as relates to money. This person who is fitting his money, he may not care about looking at women. That may not be his fitna. Na'am. So what sense would it make for him to put more guards on the door of looking than on money? No, he has to make sure that he fortifies the weakest of his doors. Na'am. And but he still has to make sure he lower his gaze too. We're not saying don't put no guards on that door. He lower his gaze. But the point is that what? You have to fortify your weaknesses. Na'am. So for the person who his weakness, for example, is intoxicants, he has to fortify himself from that weakness. So he doesn't go to those places. He doesn't hang out with those people. So on and so forth. Why? Because he knows that he has a problem with that. So he has to fortify that gate. So understand that all of the gates in which shaitan he comes at us with, the gates that are the biggest, the gates that are the most open, the gates that are the most vulnerable, then verily they are the eyes and the tongue. They are looking and talking. These are the biggest gates that shaitan he comes and he tricks the human beings by. How many people have fallen into zina because of the eye? How many people have fallen into murder because of the tongue? How many people have fallen into zina, likewise, because of the tongue, talking to women they shouldn't be talking to, or talking to men they shouldn't be talking to, so on and so forth. How many people have fallen into disrespecting their parents due to the tongue? Reflect on all of the sins that are linked to the eyes and linked to the tongue, and you will see that what, that these are from the biggest doors that shaitan attacks us from. The biggest doors. So if we want to purify our soul, we have to understand that the struggle is on, because the shaitan wants to corrupt it. The shaitan wants to destroy it. The shaitan wants to have it the epitome of what dirty can be. That's what he's trying to do. We're trying to wash it, he's trying to corrupt it. We're trying to cleanse it, he's trying to destroy it by polluting it. So we have to be on our guard. We have to be on our guard from our enemy, the shaitan. And the greatest doors that he comes to us by way of, the greatest vulnerability as relates to these doors, then verily they are the eyes and they are the tongue. So if we're going to purify our souls, then we have to be on guard as relates to it. We have to be on guard as relates to these things. Because the evil that comes when a person is lackadaisical and leaves these things unguarded is tremendous. So if we want to purify our souls, then we have to control what we are looking at. We have to lower our gaze from all those things that are haram. Gaze upon the halal. Use the eyes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you in a halal manner, in a way that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is if you are truly concerned with the purification of your soul. هذا فأقيم الصلاة.